Welcome you guys all in the third session of the prototyping of the human computer interaction design. So today we discuss in detail with all types and usage of prototyping in the HCI, and this is your host Anwar Ali. Welcome you all in the Department of Computer Science and Information Technology online classes. So here we guys go to the our topic. This is our topic, prototyping. We discuss in detail so inshallah today we discuss about the prototyping. Today the key points of discussion of today: prototyping, defining the prototyping, need importance for prototyping, types of prototypes, and prototyping as a methodology, user interface prototyping, advantages and disadvantages of prototyping, lesson learned from the session. What is the prototyping? Is the process of quickly putting together a working model prototype in order to test various aspects of a design, illustrate ideas or features, and gather early user feedback. According to Wikipedia and according to IEEE, defines prototyping as a type of development in which emphasis is placed on developing prototypes early in the development process to permit early feedback analysis in the support of the development process. So, and according to the IEEE definition, the standard definition of the prototype, such type of the development. And what is the need of the prototyping in the field of designing or development? It enable us to explore the problem space with the stakeholders, to understand the surrounding things, interact with all aspects. We understand the components of the design as a requirements artifact to initially envision the system, as a design artifact that enables us to explore the solution space of your system, a vehicle for you to communicate the possible UI designs of your system, a potential foundation from which to continue developing the system. So these are the requirements or needs. That's why we go to the prototyping modeling to understand the design before implementation. So what is the disadvantages and advantages and disadvantages of the prototyping? In the advantages, users can try the system and provide constructive feedback during development. During development, it will help us to construct a complete design without any loss or any big problem. In operational prototype, can we produce in weeks? So it will reduce the time and cost and keep us from any big loss. Users become more positive about implementing the system as they see a solution emerging that will meet their designs. Prototyping enables early detection of errors, so it will ultimately keep away us from the any loss from by the time loss or cost or any problems that will after the implementation we face. So that's a advantage. In the disadvantages of the prototyping, each situation builds on the previous situation and further refine the solution. This make it difficult to reject the initial solution as an inappropriate and start over. So initially this is a iterative process. We are redesigning the our any kind of design or development due to the help of the prototyping. So this will make it difficult to reject the initial solution. We cannot reject any kind of solution or result or target. We initially cannot reject any kind of results. In the formal end of phase, reviews do not occur. Thus, it's very difficult to contain the scope of prototype. And system documentation is often absent or incomplete, since the primary focus is a development of the prototype. And last one, fourth, is system backup and recovery performance and security issues can be overlooked. So these are also problematic. System backup and recovery performance and security issues can be overlooked due to the iterative process redesigning. These factors overlooked due to the wastage of time, the limitations due to the budget, time constraint, budget constraint, and space other type of such constraints can stop us to look detail in these factors. So these are the advantage of the prototyping. Journey of the programming process is realized from the start from the goal we set before going to the design, the functionality of these goals required, the development process, and we finally evaluate the all design. So this is the process of the evaluate the design before implementation during a development process. Types of prototyping: we have throwaway prototyping, evolutionary prototyping, low fidelity prototyping, high fidelity. Previously we discussed about the low and high fidelity. Here we have throwaway prototyping, evolutionary prototyping. So we discuss in detail afterwards. Throwaway prototype is such a way is developed from the initial requirements but is not used for the final project. Written specifications of the requirements. Some developers believe that this type is a waste of the time because you don't use it. So regardless if a prototype is discarded or kept for production, you must use the easy to use language. And advantage and disadvantage of this type of the throwaway: significantly reduced project risk, has a short project timeline, and this prototype actually does not, it's just presentation only for a limited purpose, starting become a thing of the past, not getting used as a much now. So this is the in the evolutionary project prototype. Evolutionary prototype is considered the most fundamental form of the prototype. Evolutionary prototype main concept is to build a robust prototype and constantly improve it and till the completion of the goal. Objective to deliver a working system to the end user, and according to the Steve McNeil, evolutionary delivery is a life cycle model that straddles the ground between evolutionary prototyping and state delivery. So this is the evolutionary prototyping. In the evolutionary prototyping, we have as software concepts, a construction model, parliamentary requirements analysis, and then design of architecture and system code. After that, develop a variant. This variant can be deliver final variant, or either we deliver the variant and elicit customer feedback to improve the design again and again, incorporate customer feedback, interact with the users and design to develop this process again and again till the final delivery of the target. So this evolution process can be repeated again and again according to the design of architecture and system core. So here we have in the design core, we have two phases. One is when we are inside architecture design system code, we repeating again and again to the complete the construction modeling. After that, when we are into the jump into the development variant, we can repeat this process again and again till the final repetition. So this phase is evolutionary, two phases variant of the evolutionary delivery in the prototyping. Here we have defining another way, define the basic requirements and create a working prototype. We know that working prototype is such like a high fidelity implementation model verification of the working prototype. It can be verified using the feasibility of the implementation of the any kind of utility or application, and evaluate and deliberately requirements can be checked, analyzed for the complete according to the defined requirements. So this is the repetitive process till the completion of them. The advantage of this process is that you are always looking for new ways to improve the system. This is a progressive model, improved all the times according to the feedback. This model increases the chance of having the client satisfied with the working system. We say that it's satisfying the users, interactive user design. In the interactive user design, we satisfying the user according to the design, so that we complete the design according to the needs of the users or the client or the customer. The model can be used even when the requirements are not defined. So requirements are sometimes are fully not defined, but it can, the model also can use, can be used by the, any kind of. So quicker delivery of the system. The advantage of the quicker delivery, we know that the before checking the all requirements meeting meet or not, we can implement. So this is a quicker delivery system. Disadvantage of that system, this method can be used to avoid documenting the requirements of the system. So documentation can be avoided. When documentation avoided, then we cannot analyze the complete implementation and checking of the system. Management is required to repeat it to process. Management is always required to in the progressive manner. Long term maintenance can be expensive. When we have the long term progressive manner, all times we are in the development phase, then we need the long term maintenance can be very expensive and costly. It will stop us in certain position. In certain design ideas, uncertain design ideas, it will stuck, we can stuck somewhere due to the uncertainty of the design ideas. Information can be lost through so many improvement changes. So these are the disadvantages of them. The low fidelity prototyping, we know that a low fidelity prototyping is a generally limited function and limited interaction prototyping efforts, and they are constructed to depict concept, design alternatives and screen layouts. They are intended to demonstrate general look and feel of the interface. They are created to educate, communicate and inform, but not to train, test or serve. Here we have three. It cannot be used for the training purpose, testing or serving purpose, and this is by which you to code. So this is just like a this is a typing or writing phase, conception modeling. Here we just sketching all the information in, on the paper. Low fidelity prototyping is used early in the design cycle to show general conceptual approaches without much investment in the development. So there is no concept of development in the field, in the area of low fidelity. We just are verbal, and we are just a verbal, and in the high fidelity prototyping, high fidelity prototyping present the core functionality of the product's user interface. So here we have the using the multimedia applications to show the real applications performance or outlook or the design. So in high fidelity prototypes are fully interactive systems. Users can enter data and entry fields, they respond to messages, select icon to open windows and interact with the user interface as it if it were a real system. Such like a real system, it will interact simulator. A simulator is not a real, but it will simulate you and train you understand the system. So that's a high fidelity prototyping. They trade off speed of accuracy. Building high fidelity prototypes consume resources and have a high cost. So although we have a very big investment in the high fidelity prototyping, but with the failure of the system will be decreased. the ratio of value, system failure or design failure will be decreased in the high fidelity prototyping. We have two comparison of the two prototyping efforts, low fidelity and high fidelity. Advantage is low fidelity will have lower development cost. We know cost to investment in the implementation. Just taking papers and drawing the design, redesigning, evaluate multiple design concepts, useful communication device, address screen layout issues. All issues can be addressed easily. Address screen layout issues useful for identifying requirements. And here we have the disadvantage of the low fidelity, limited error checking. Because we are in the concept modeling when the verbal texting type, so we cannot check the implementation or development consequences in the on the paperwork. Facilitator driven limited utility after requirements established, navigational and flow limitations. We can navigate our flow due to the limitation of the paper size or the board size. We cannot implement the whole system on the paper or on the board to show up the connectivity, the mapping or the relationship between the components or utilities. Poor detail, especially into the code. In the high fidelity prototypes, so we have the advantages. Complete functionality can be expressed fully and fully interactive. Design can be driven, user driven, clear definition of navigation, explained look and feel of final products used for exploration and test. In the disadvantage, we have more expensive to develop. We have much cost to develop before going to the implementation or design. Time consuming to create the high fidelity prototypes, not effective for requirements gathering. So these are the disadvantages of the what is the prototype best methodology applied in the so here we have the problem requirements, through our prototype demonstration and investigations, and model prototyping, simulation or formal verification, system implementations, testing and training, performance analysis. So these are the methodologies. A preliminary design of the system is built using throwaway prototyping, conceptual modeling, throwaway prototyping, a demonstration and to end user. Or we say the throwaway prototyping or the system analysis before going to the implementation or conceptual modeling of any kind of creative design. So we need the throwaway system prototyping, preparation before design. Demonstration to end users, as well investigations on this prototype, allows for the design of more precise requirements as well as the evolution of techniques to be used in the final system. So, and refinements on throwaway prototype concerning the requirements are done. Evolutionary prototyping used to build a model prototype. Accurate and complete description of the system. These prototypes can be studied under various simulated conditions. So simulators are applied for testing purposes, to test or compare the prototyping model. Refinement on the model prototyping concerning the actual system is done and final system is rolled out after testing. So after the testing and compare with the prototyping, actual system can be launched. User interface prototyping. So in the user interface prototyping, development of the high interactive software system with graphical user interfaces has become increasingly common, and acceptance of the such a system depends on highly on the quality of GUI. So user and graphical user interface presentation will appeal the users. If they are very interactive, they are very easy to use, the they will appeal the users and end user or interactive user can easily interact with the system. So user interface prototype is very helpful. Prototype is an excellent means of generating ideas about how the GUI can be designed, and it helps to evaluate quality of solution at any early stage. Classification of user interface prototypes are presentation of prototypes, functional prototypes, breadboard prototypes, and pilot systems. So these are the interface prototypes classification. Now we have risk in prototyping. Client may believe in that system is real. So near to reality, unrealistic expectations of the progress. Implementers make poor choice. So justified in prototype but not in real system. Tempting to build real system same way. And the prototype is not identical to the real system. So they are both not in same pattern, so they may be risk. User may interact differently due to the different responsible characters. Must interpret prototype experience with care. Do we need the prototyping? Two points of interest for companies to adopt prototype based methodology are: point one is that they allow us to reduce the cost and time to market of system. And second point is that for companies building critical systems, prototyping would help them perform formal verification when required. These methodologies provide high level of reliability in the system design and implementation. We know that before in the NASA, before going to the any launching any kind of mission, they are using the prototype testing here on the Earth to minimize the losses and verify the durability and the stability of the system. So all companies, all the any kind of developers, before going to the any design, they have the check their design completion, their factors, their risks are calculated to analyze all the systems by prototyping before going to the implementation. So they will keep them away from the any loss or any problem. So this is the simulators used to train the people. So simulators are not the real system, but they are the prototypes for any kind of in the Airbus. They will help to understand the all consequences. In the key learning, we know that a prototype can be used to give end users a concrete impression of the system's capabilities. And the prototype has become increasingly used for the system development where rapid development is essential. Through a prototype is used to understand the system requirements, or we understand the analyze the system to achieve the goal. In the evolutionary prototype, the system is developed by the evolving an initial variant to the final variant. And the key points are rapid development of prototypes is essential. This may require leaving out functionality or lessening non-functional constraints. Prototyping techniques include the use of very high level language, database programming, and prototype construction from reusable components. And third point is that prototype is essential for parts of the system such as the user interface, which cannot be effective pre-specified. User must be involved in the prototype evolution. So thank you very much. Any questions you may ask, and through emails or my other channels, WhatsApp or any kind of Google Classroom. Thank you very much for engaging. This is the bibliography used in this session. Okay guys, hopefully you understand all the detailed information about the prototype. Thank you very much.